I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
I love you.
Love, an emotion that we've all seen, felt, or heard about in our lifetime. From romantic movies, poems, songs on the radio, to even a day dedicated purely to love. We can't escape it. We talk about the moment of falling in love. It can be intense and overwhelming. You may start to feel nervous around the person you admire. Your heart begins to race. You can't sleep. You keep thinking about them, or you experience a loss of appetite. But is our heart really to blame for all of this? No. For many centuries, people thought that love and other emotions arose from the heart. It turns out love is all about the brain, which in turn causes your body to go crazy. Love, as defined by Merriam-Webster, is a strong affection for another arising out of kinship or personal ties, or attraction based on sexual desire or affection based on admiration. Much of love can be explained by understanding the chemistry involved in the brain. We've all experienced different kinds of love, like the one between you and your partner, your parents, or your friends. In a study conducted by Dr. Helen Fisher, an expert on the biological basis of love and attachment, romantic love can be broken down into three categories: lust, attraction, and attachment. Though these types of love overlap, they are each characterized by a different set of hormones. Lust, the evolutionary basis for this type of love, stems from our need to reproduce. It is driven by the desire for sexual gratification. The hypothalamus stimulates the production of sex hormones such as testosterone and estrogen that drive the stage of love. In a study conducted by James Simon, 283 women who have hypoactive sexual desire disorder were recruited for a study. The disorder is defined as a chronic or recurrent deficit in or absence of sexual activity that causes personal distress. The women either received a placebo patch or a testosterone patch. The endpoint was to measure the change in the frequency of total satisfying sexual activity. At 24 weeks, sexual activity in the testosterone group was significantly greater than in the placebo group, thus showing the impact of sex hormones on our feeling. Attraction involves the brain's pathway that controls reward behavior. Dopamine, norepinephrine, and serotonin are the hormones involved. Dopamine, produced by the hypothalamus, is released when we do things that feel good to us. Norepinephrine is released and makes us giddy and excited. It underlies the fight or flight response, which is why our heart rate can increase. It also decreases appetite and can cause insomnia. So this is where you get the feeling that you're so in love that you can't eat or sleep. Serotonin, which is a natural mood stabilizer, is reduced. It also changes appetite and mood. Low levels of serotonin are involved with increased libido. In a study conducted by Helen Fisher, 17 individuals who were insanely in love are recruited and shown pictures of their beloved. To determine neural mechanisms associated with romantic love, a functional magnetic resonance imaging machine was used. Data show that attraction or romantic love is associated with dopaminergic pathways in the reward system and is primarily a motivation system, which leads to various emotions. This scene in Scott Pilgrim vs. the World is an example of attraction. When Scott first meets Ramona, he's excited, chatty, and nervous. Just take a look at his cup. Lastly, oxytocin and vasopressin are involved in attachment, which is the bond that is involved in long-lasting commitments like friendships or parent-infant relationships. Oxytocin is produced by the hypothalamus and is released during childbirth, sex, and breastfeeding. It's a precursor to bonding. In another study, 47 couples were given either oxytocin or placebo before a couple conflict discussion. In the oxytocin group, positive communication was significantly increased, including eye contact, nonverbal positive behaviors, curiosity and care, and agreement. These findings imply that the involvement of oxytocin in couple interactions and close relationships in humans is vital. We see this kind of attachment when Barney first meets his daughter in How I Met Your Mother. But love is often accompanied by negative behaviors, like jealousy and irrationality. The same hormones that produce the exhilarating feeling of love are also responsible for the downsides. Additionally, oxytocin may be responsible for feel-good effects. However, in extreme cases, it can cause an individual to disassociate from their environment and act wildly. Finally, sexual arousal can turn off parts of our brain that regulate critical thinking and rational behavior. In short, love is a complicated equation.